Hong Kong Stock Exchange Directors Training. Responsibilities of directors of companies listed on the main board of the Hong Kong Stock Exchange. 3. Consequence of non-compliance with the main board rules. Under the main board rules 2A.09, if a director breaches any of the main board rules, the exchange may respond with disciplinary procedures, including but not limited to issuing a private reprimand, issuing a public statement which involves criticism, issuing a public censure, reporting the offender's conduct to a regulatory authority, for example, the Securities and Futures Commission, the SFC, or to an overseas regulatory authority, requiring a breach to be rectified or other remedial action taken within a stipulated period, and taking or refraining from taking such other action as the exchange thinks fit. If the exchange considers that the listed issuer failed in a material manner to comply with the main board rules, the exchange may, under Board Rule 6.01(1), suspend dealings in the issuer's securities or cancel the listing of the issuer's securities. Directors should also be aware that it is a criminal offence under Section 384 of the SFO to intentionally or recklessly provide any information which is false or misleading in a material particular in any public disclosure document filed with the Exchange or the SFC. This will include any document filed under the Listing Rules continuing disclosure obligations. The offence carries a maximum penalty of 2 years imprisonment and a fine of HK$1 million. Under Section 214 of the SFO, the court may make orders disqualifying a person from being a director of any corporation for up to 15 years if he is found to be wholly or partly responsible for the misconduct of a company's affairs. Misconduct for these purposes will include where shareholders have not been given all the information with respect to the company's business or affairs which they might reasonably expect. In March 2010, the SFC disqualified two former executive directors of Warderly International Holdings Limited for 5 years for failing to inform the company's shareholders that the company was in a substantially depleted financial position. Directors' personal particulars and contact information. Under Main Board Rule 3.09A, in accepting to be a director of a listed issuer, directors shall be considered as having irrevocably appointed the listed issuer as their agent for as long as they remain directors of the listed issuer, for receiving on their behalf any correspondence from and or service of notice and other documents by the exchange, and authorize the disclosure of any of the directors' personal particulars to members of the listing committee and with the approval of the chairman or deputy chairman of the exchange to such other persons as the executive director of listing may from time to time think fit. Main Board Rule 3.20 requires directors of a listed issuer to inform the exchange in the manner prescribed by the exchange from time to time the following contact information: telephone number, mobile phone number, fax email number, if available, email address, if available, residential and contact address, if different from the residential address. As soon as reasonably practicable after their appointment for correspondence from and service of notices and other documents by the exchange. For so long as they remain as directors of the issuer, any change to the contact information as described above, as soon as reasonably practicable, and in any event within 28 days of such change, and for a period of 3 years from the date on which they cease to be directors of the issuer, any change to the contact information as described above, as soon as reasonably practicable, and in any event within 28 days of such change. Any correspondence from and or service of notices and other by the exchange to the directors, when they are directors of the listed issuer, or after they cease to be so, for whatever purposes, including but not limited to the service of notice of disciplinary proceedings, shall be deemed to have been validly and adequately served on them, when the document or notice is served personally, or is sent by post, facsimile, or email to the address or number they provide to the exchange. It is the responsibility of directors and former directors to keep the exchange informed of their up-to-date contact details. If directors or former directors fail to provide the exchange with their up-to-date contact details or arrange for notices, documents, or correspondence to be forwarded to them, they may not be alerted to any proceedings commenced against them by the exchange.